Greetings, family. Greetings. I greet you all in the name of Jesus Christ, our Savior. Family, I will give you Bible verses about going to church, or Bible verses about church attendance. Also, family, I will explain. And in this dream, family, I tell you what happened, what you learn from it. Family, you know it's our responsibility as believers to spread the word of God in Jesus' name. Not so. Family, in this dream, I was somewhere. I met some people, friends. I met them, and I was like, they had a meeting. We were somewhere sitting, gathered. I was like, oh, friends, how are you doing? How are you all? I greet you all. They're like, oh, we are fine. How are you, Junior? How are you, Junior? I told them, I'm fine. But you guys, these days, I don't see you in church. What's happening? You're no longer coming to church, you know. I don't know, you know, what's happening? Tell me. They were like, Amon, we don't know what to say for sure, but I think Amon, we are so disappointed with those church things. For sure, no. I told them, no, what's going on? Explain to me. Maybe I may be of help. You never know. There are reasons why people meet. And they're like, Amon, you know, when we go to church, are those pastors? Amon, I don't know. They preach looking at you. They preach pointing at you. They preach like maybe insulting you. They talk about the laziness. You know, Amon, some of us are lazy. They talk about our laziness. Amon, those pastors talk about the things we do, the fornication things. Amon, pastors talk about how we dress. And they say you're not dressing well. But again, they talk about the dressing code. It's like as if they are talking about you, you know, they are looking at you. It's like, you know, Amon, they ask questions, you know. I know, Amon, we are disappointed. No, Junior, we are disappointed. Maybe those church things, maybe church is not our place to go. I was like, okay, go on. I'll talk to you. Go on. They're like, yes, we've told you. Because you wanted to know, now you've known. I told them, my sister and brothers, that's the reason why you're not coming to church. Yes, they said yes. Amon, because you know, when they see you, it's like maybe the pastor saw us somewhere. That's when they talk about adultery. And you know, Amon, some people are in adultery. I know some of us are in adultery. That's what they are saying. I told them, okay, go on. They're like, yeah, we've said everything. Please, if you are to help, we've told you everything. Not so. I told them, family, I'm going to explain to you. I'm going to tell you, don't worry. I know there are reasons why people meet. So there's a reason why I've met you. Not so. That's where the dream ended while I was going to explain to these people. Family, first of all, what do you learn from this dream? Before we go to the Bible verses and I explain as I conclude. Family, yes. Family, for sure, whenever you go to church, maybe you're going to church, and there is a situation that pastor or maybe someone and they talk about that situation, and you feel for sure they are attacking you. Maybe laziness, maybe poor dress code, maybe misconduct, maybe bad behavior, maybe things like adultery, maybe things like alcoholism, things like fornication, and you're like, they're talking about you. Family, what are you waiting for? That means the Holy Spirit is telling you something. That Spirit is telling you, my son, my daughter, come back. Not that they are insulting. That's not insulting. That's never insulting. Let me tell you. Some of you are not going to church because of this. Yes, I know. You know, I told you, God gives us this dream so that we can be able to tell people. I know people, you also receive dreams. So some of you may not get the chance maybe to share them. Not so. Some of you share them as testimonies. Yes, thank you. Some of you, but I will tell you, you may talk to someone. Not so. You'll get help. Family, it's not insulting, but the Spirit is telling you something. My son, come back before it's too late. Not so. Family, let me give you Bible verses about going to church, in church attendance. Not so. Family, go and read Hebrews chapter 10, verse 25. Go and read Matthew chapter 18, verse 20. Go and read Colossians chapter 3, verse 16. Go and read Romans chapter 10, verse 17. Go and read Matthew chapter 16, verse 18. Go and read Acts chapter 9, verse 31 to 32. Go and read Matthew chapter 6, verse 33. Go and read James chapter 1, verse 22. Go and read Ephesians chapter 4, verse 12. Go and read 2 Timothy chapter 4, verse 12. Go and read Matthew chapter 28, verse 19 to 20. Go and read Malachi chapter 3, verse 10. Family, in these Bible verses, you see this the word of God saying. Of course, you go and read the other verses. No, so I just give you a little. Others, you go and read them yourself. Family, you see, you had written not giving up meeting together, encourage one another. Yes, family, I always tell you, when you like, so you're in church, like, and maybe you're like, so and so did not come, and some of you have you even have your contacts, even some of you are your neighbors. Make sure you know why didn't so and so come. Not so. Talk to them. Maybe they're in a problem. No, maybe. And this is the time when they need you most. Some of you don't know this. You share your happiness with people. So when there are people and they are in, maybe they're so, talk to them. Encourage them. What are families for? We all say we are family. When we are church, we say we are family. That's how a family works. From another thing you see, for where two or three gather in my name, there am I with them. Amen. Message of Christ dwell among you. Yes, the message of Christ will dwell among you. In hymns, in songs, it is. If you're in church, we fellowship, we sing, we know, we dance with the Lord. Most of you in church, even in church, cannot dance. And when in other places, you dance. So tell me, if you can't dance for the Lord, whom will you dance for? If you can't dance for this, some of you are like, even at home, you dance. Yes. But there's a reason why you're supposed to go to church. I'm still telling you. Another thing is, a faith comes from hearing the message. Yes. And you see what is written, on this rock I will build my church, and the gates of heads will not overcome it. Amen. But seek first his kingdom and his righteousness, and all this shall be given to you as well. Yes. Family, I always share this. Sorry, family. Even Presiding Apostle received this, Presiding Apostle Serada, doing his programs on Dream TV and Impact. If you want him, go on amcg.ug. Who says it? Family, may I go to save? Because I want to go to heaven. I always say this. But some of you are like, oh, you get saved, you'll get a car. You get saved, you'll get this and this. You get... Seek ye first the kingdom of God. Seek ye first his kingdom and his righteousness, and all these things shall be given to you as well. Some of you are like, you want money, you know, you want to be rich. Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all the things shall be given unto you. Family, you have to know this. Apostle said the reason why he got saved is also to go to heaven. Who doesn't want heaven? What do you gain from having those vehicles, but when they are not holy, when they are not from God? Family. Okay. And another thing is, do not listen to the word and deceive yourselves. Do what it says. Yes. Some of you are like, you are believers, but in fornication, you're number one. In stealing, you're number one. In alcoholism, drunkenness, you're number one. Abusing, you're number one. Bad behavior, you're number one. Insulting others, you're number one. And you say, I'm a believer. Who told you? You mean being a believer is just when you go accept Jesus Christ as your own personal savior, you go, yes, you're baptized, then you're a believer? That's what you think? That's why I'm telling you, go to church. Then you need to know more. Go to church, family. Another thing is, to equip his people for works of service so that the body of Christ may be built up. Yes. How do we get the preachers, the pastors? How do we get them? How do we help in the service of God? They will not come in your homes and say, please, no, no, please. You are equipped, you are trained. It's a training, you're brought up. They are training you. And for the service, you end up becoming a pastor. Yes. It's from coming from church. Some classes, believers' classes, you know. Go for Bible study, Sunday school, baptism classes. You're baptized. That's all. That's all preparation, preparing you for the service. You don't just jump into things. You must know the word. Okay, but another thing is, preach the word, yes. Be prepared in season and out of season. Be prepared in season and out of season. Yes, family, if a season of happiness, it's okay. You need God. Season of sorrow, yes, you need God. Some of you are like, when you're in sorrow, you go to God. When you're in happiness, don't mind. Oh, God, I need a father. Oh, after getting rich, you have a car. You're in your hammer driving, you see the church. Sunday, you're like, I'm going outing. No, church. I'll go there next time. When you don't, and yet you don't know that in, through this happiness, this happiness, this is when the devil, in most cases, attacks you. It attacks you more. For me, I know, let me tell you this. For me, I know. I always want to give examples about me in most cases, with other people. For me, I know. I knew before I knew that when you're in Christ, when you're in labor, when you're in Holy Spirit, you know, you're not attacked. That's what I knew. But family, I'm telling, this is when the devil attacks you more. Remember, from our mentor, Jesus, our Savior, he was attacked. Imagine, the devil was attacking Jesus. Satan was attacking Jesus, telling him, if you're a son of God, and you're making this into bread, so and so. Not knowing that it is attacking someone of, I don't know even. So you attacked. You have to know this. Okay. Mm-hmm. Go and make disciples of all nations. Yes, family, just use it. Spread the word of God. You have to be fruitful. I always tell you, you have to be fruitful. Being fruitful is not only they said, yes, we shall marry, we shall have kids. Then I'm fruitful. Who told you? Use that word of God. Use the word of God, you know. Tell others. Talk to others. Let others know the word of God. Touch people. Touch people and God will help you. We shall win souls through Jesus Christ our Savior. For you can, but I know God will help you do it. Bring the whole tithe into the house, the storehouse, that there may be food in the house. Yes! I tell you, we are the church. So, how will the church be there? The church services. You say you want books, you want these days you're like, you want even to sing when the things are on the projectors. So how will those things come? How will they happen? Some of you, like, you want to sing for the Lord, you know. And you know, worshiping is also is worshiping and singing is also one of the strongest points where we hit the devil. And you're like, you want even speakers, you know. You're like, that church doesn't have speakers, but you're not going to church. Yeah. So where will the speakers come from? You Thanksgiving, you're not there. The tithing, you're not there. You know, your father, you're not there. So what do you expect? What's wrong, people? Family, I'm not judging you. No, please. And I always tell you, I tell you what you must hear, not what you want to hear. I love you so much, family. I'm on Junior Rukundo Facebook, Urangana Magaragani Facebook, Kisugu Uganda, to my email Facebook, Facebook accounts, Twitter at Amon Junior, Instagram Amon Junior 1651987. There's Facebook page for God and Our Heaven Raj page. Go there, like those videos, share them, and sharing them, that means you're helping us, you're helping me spread the word of God. There's YouTube account, Love Amon Junior or Amon Junior Rukundo. Go there, subscribe, share those videos. In sharing them, yeah, we are spreading the word of God and you'll be blessed in Jesus' name. Not so. Some another thing is, you've not yet accepted Jesus Christ as your only personal Savior. What are you waiting for? You're like, I still have time. So and so did it at the end. I'm still young. I'm not a sinner. Why should I hurry? After long, I know I go to church. That's not it, family. You have to accept Jesus Christ as your only personal Savior. Not so. Like they say, seek ye first the kingdom of God, and the rest, and his righteousness, the rest shall be added unto you. Not so. And you know, family, I always tell you, you are born sinners. You know this. I always tell you, some of you don't know this. Right from Adam and Eve. That's why he sent his son, so that we might be saved. And I think you have to be baptized. Some of you are like, I was baptized when I was young. Now why should I hurry? You accept Jesus Christ as your own personal Savior. You confess. You flee those sins. So you're saying you were baptized when you were young. You showed the photos when you were carrying you. So when did you confess? And you're saying somebody confessed for me. Really? Go and talk to the pastor. Go and talk to your pastor. Go and talk to the apostles, the bishops. They will guide you and other church leaders, our leaders. Not so. They will guide you on how to do it. Not so. Family, I love you so much, family. God bless you. In Jesus' name. Amen.